Damn.
I take it you're Lincoln Clay.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant it figuratively. This shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally a pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here. Right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net. Cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, oh, I don't know, 20 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, do you?
No, sir.
In exchange, you run things as you see fit. You sell heroin, a whorehouse on every other corner. Makes no fucking difference to me. The only thing that matters is 20%.
What if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
And this will be the last time we see each other. Best of luck to you, son.
Do the 20% goes to? That's what I want to know. Oh, I just thought about something. Let's go get that last painting. Then I have 100% of all collectibles. Yeah, I want to know who the 20% goes to. If we have to give 20% of our revenue from what we earn from the city, who's that go to, and can I take him out? It's like you went all the way up to San Marcano, big top dog, and actually he's actually the bottom of the chain in a bigger enterprise. I think he'd go after them next. He's a badass, he could do anything. I wonder if we see Georgie still in there. No. Oh, there he is. Nice. Yeah, see that, guys. 100%, 100%, 100%, 100%, 100%, 100%. Yeah. a bit of a completionist. I would show you all the pictures, but obviously I can't. YouTube's have rules on nudity and things like that. What the heck was that? That's really creeped me out. I'm getting the heck out of it. It's still rustling. This place is haunted. Well, I'm not surprised. There's a dead body. Of course this place is going to be haunted now. We got one last mission, I think. Yeah, before they bury you.
This is New Bordeaux News. The police and fire department are still combing through the wreckage of the unlicensed casino complex under development in the northern unincorporated section of New Bordeaux.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see them.
Sketchy, but police discovered multiple bodies in what was clearly a gun battle with an unknown number of assailants at the planned resort. Convicted felon Salvatore Marcano and his son Georgie have been identified among the dead. Listeners may recall the ongoing initiative to legalize gambling in New Bordeaux, which was unable to pass a city council vote. More recently, the measure was headed before the circuit court for review. However, the apparent assassination of sitting Judge Cornelius Holden has stalled proceedings. We'll keep you updated with more details of this breaking story.
I wonder if anyone is actually that skilled that they could take out that many people in this world. They'd be a very scary person, I'd have thought. No, I didn't see the police there. They work really quick, these police. They must have walked out the door, they walked in, I didn't even see them, and they didn't even bother arresting me. Madness. No way he shuts his door, good man.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over, done, finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
When Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough, it doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Hey.
You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California? Leave all this behind?
and just start all over?
Yeah.
Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go! And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
Bob.
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
Time to move on. If I can take a whole city, or Lincoln Clay can take a whole city, there ain't nothing standing in his way. It's time to leave, move on, and forget my past. My friends own a part of the city and they're all safe now and happy, so it's definitely time to move on.
After Lincoln vanished, Cassandra took control of the city's underworld. It wasn't a crime boss from Boston to Miami who respected her claim, though, so... Commission, the Colombians, the Cubans, they all went after her. They realized too late they had no idea who they were fighting. Johnny Galante, throat slit, watching Deep Throat in a porn theater. And Manny Moreno, set on fire outside his daughter's quinceañera. Severo Garcia, buried alive on the beach, drowned when the tide came in. Anton Bagrov, beaten to death with crowbars in the parking lot of the Briar Patch. And then the real criminals came for her. The governor declared martial law, sent in the National Guard. So, Cassandra shot him in the head on the steps of the Capitol building. After that, everyone got the message. The city belonged to Cassandra. But the government is like a rogue elephant. It's murderous and patient and never forgets. So the state pulled funding for the schools, city maintenance, you name it. If they couldn't get Cassandra, it strangled the city until it gave her up. Hurricane Cassandra, the locals called it. I don't think anyone expected the damage to be so severe that the levees would completely fail. that the flooding would wipe out half the city and force the other half to leave. That the city would turn into the ghost town it is today. It's hard to believe, really. A major American city left to rot like that. Some say Cassandra was one of the thousands who drowned in the flood. Others say she slipped away to the swamps and still rules what's left of the city's underworld from the bayou. Either way, she's a ghost. She hasn't been seen in years. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Langan made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. He started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. Though I think Langan wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running, or make a mistake, and I'll be waiting. I promise you that. Hold my head. Oh, baby,
it's a long way down to the bottom of the river. Hold my head. What a game, everyone. thoroughly enjoy. Anyway, guys, that's been the Mafia 3 walkthrough. I hope everyone has enjoyed it, as I have thoroughly enjoyed it. But anyway, guys, I'll catch you next time. Enjoy the rest of your day. See ya.
Something. Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember at home, I believe.
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman. Cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do
with... What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Sit down and shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So, to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me, and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered? Well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right, no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assumed you would say that.
Don't fucking move! You're out of your mind.
I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again! The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help.
There are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you
them
never
to
get away with this,
you stupid asshole. Because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you. And they're next. Gentlemen.
God!